I like math. I like modeling. I like computers. But what I want to do is be able to use it to help people. And so it's really interesting or kind of exciting that we can use these tools in helping in this humanitarian cause.
Although the Food Bank of Central and Eastern North Carolina is the largest in the state, they still can't reach everyone.
I don't think people realize the magnitude of food insecurity. We believe there are about 680,000 people that are food insecure at some point during the month. We can't get enough food in to solve the problem.
Enter Dr. Ivy and Dr. Davis. They're engineers who realized analytics could revolutionize how food banks operate. They reached out to see how they could help.
The food bank gave us tons of data. And, you know, initially we're like, data, data, data. But data can be like a blessing and a curse.
They mined through millions of records and translated the numbers into useful information.
Some of the models that we have developed try to predict the amount of food that might be donated. The other type of models also try to estimate how many people might be in need of food. We try to pull in data about unemployment, poverty, to see if we can get a better estimate of the true need in the counties that they serve.
That information gives the food bank an efficient way to predict changes in supply and demand, so they can reduce food waste while maximizing the number of people they can reach.
What they have done is given us why we should do certain things and how we should do them. But instead of saying, well, that just feels right, we're able to say, well, the data tells us. It's pretty cool stuff.
We're making an impact, and we have the potential to do so much more. The work we do is easily applicable to other food banks, and I think that we'll be able to figure out how to, you know, reduce the number of families who have hunger needs.